Hello everyone, welcome to Honora's Arts and Lifestyle channel. In today's video, I will be telling you all about the Hindu festival which is celebrated in Kerala called as Vishu. I suggest you all to watch this video even though you are not from Kerala, because in this video I'll be giving you lots and lots of information about the favorite things for Lord Krishna so that you can offer it during either Krishna Janmashtami or any other festivals or occasions. For this festival, there is a lot of preparation which is required to do the setting for the Vishu Kani. So I will be telling you the details of all of these items, and in the subsequent videos I will also be showing you on how to make some of these items right at your home rather than buying it from outside. So please don't miss to watch this video till the end and also the upcoming videos to know more about Vishu Kani. Vishu is a Hindu festival which is celebrated in Kerala and in Tulu Nadu region in Karnataka. It is also celebrated in Mahe district of Pondicherry in Tamil Nadu. Vishu marks the first day of the astronomical year, and hence Lord Vishnu and his incarnation Lord Krishna are worshipped on the day of Vishu, as Lord Vishu is considered as the god of time. Vishu marks the first day of the month called Madam. Just like the way we are going to celebrate Yugadi or Gudi Padwa as a Hindu New Year, similarly in Kerala, they celebrate Vishu festival as the first day of the Hindu calendar. It was on this day that Lord Krishna killed the demon Narakasura, and because of this, Krishna's idols are kept in the Vishu Kani. Kani means that which is seen first, and hence Vishu Kani means that which is seen first on the Vishu festival. It is believed that the new year will be better if one views auspicious and joyful things as the first thing on Vishu. So the rituals which are being followed for this Vishu Kani are like this. The setting for Vishu Kani is done on the previous day, and this setting will include Lord Krishna being placed and a lot of items which are being offered to Lord Krishna. I'll be telling you about all of these items in a minute. On the day of Vishu, one of the family members, usually the mother or an elderly person, wakes up at dawn, has bath and wears new clothes and lights up the lamps and does Agarbatti Arati. Then, this person will go to each and every member of her family one by one and blindfolds them and wakes each one of them up and walks them to the front of the setting. She then releases the blindfold so one can see the setting and then greets for the Vishu day. There are several items which are being kept in front of Lord Krishna for Vishu Kani, and the items are as follows. An idol of Krishna or a photograph of Krishna is being kept as the main thing in the Vishu setting. And then there will be lots of items which are in golden yellow color which are being kept in this setting. This includes a flower which is golden yellow in color and it is called as golden blossoms, also called as Kanikonna in Malayalam. And this is also called as Cassia Fistula. There will be coins and currency notes which are also kept in this setting, and new clothes, and a very special type of mirror which is made out of metal, which is also called as Val Kannadi. So here is a picture of an authenticated and original Val Kannadi which is available. But usually this kind of a Val Kannadi is very expensive, and that is the reason people don't tend to keep the exact kind of Val Kannadi. So some of the families will be keeping ordinary mirrors as Val Kannadi is becoming expensive. This setting will also include rice and other harvest products being kept. And this setting will also include lots and lots of fruits and vegetables which are golden yellow in color, such as lemon, yellow cucumber, jackfruit, mango, bananas, and so on. The setting will also include Kanmashi Kajal and betel nut leaves and Arake nut, brass oil lamps. Again, brass is being chosen over here because it is golden yellow in color. And the setting will also include keeping holy Hindu texts such as Bhagavad Gita or Ramayana or Sri Devi Mahatmya and so on. This setting will also include in keeping jewelry which is made out of gold. And many of these items will be offered on a brass plate or on a brass uruli. The setting will also include jaggery and a coconut which is broken into two parts. And each one of these parts will be filled with oil and a wick will be placed in the middle and converted into a lamp. And not just that, this setting will also include something called as Thiru Udayada, which is a fan kind of a thing which is Krishna's favorite. The timings for Vishukani is usually 2 hours before the sunrise. And this year in India, the timing for Vishukani is going to be 2:45 a.m. on 14th of April. This setting will also include a very special shiny red seeds which are called as Manjadi seeds. This is something which is very, very, very favorite for Lord Krishna. So once the setting is ready, we will also have to keep agarbattis ready so that when the elderly person wakes up in the dawn on Vishu day, they will be able to light the lamp directly and offer few flowers and then offer agarbatti arati and immediately wake up the rest of the family members by blindfolding them. People also visit temples like Shabarimala, Ayyappan or Guruvayur Sri Krishna temple during Vishu. There is also another tradition called Vishukai Neetam, which is being followed during the Vishu, wherein the elders of the family give money to the younger ones. And this is considered as a blessing from the family by exchanging the money. Another tradition which is being followed during Vishu is called as Pudu Kodi or Vishu Kodi. This is the tradition of buying new clothes for Vishu. People also give alms and contribute to community charity during Vishu. Children also follow another tradition which is called as Vishu Padakan, which is nothing but bursting firecrackers during the Vishu festival. The special meal which is prepared during Vishu is called as Vishu Sadhya, wherein Sadhya means feast. This Vishu Sadhya includes several dishes. One of the dishes of Vishu Sadhya is called as Vishu Kanni, which is made out of rice, coconut milk and spices. They also make something called as Toran and Vishukatta. Vishukatta is made out of freshly harvested rice powder, coconut milk and jaggery. And this Vishu Sadhya also includes something called as Veppam Purasam, which is a bitter preparation of neem leaves. They also make something called as Bevu Bella, which is nothing but a mixture of sweet jaggery and bitter neem. The mixing of sweet, salty, sour, bitter and astringent flavors for the New Year Vishu meal is similar to the pachadi food prepared on the New Year day such as Yugadi by Hindus in Karnataka, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. So this completes the rituals to be followed for the Vishu festival. I hope you all have liked this video. If so, please click on the like button and subscribe to my channel and don't miss to watch the subsequent videos which are related to Vishu. Thank you.